Hello and welcome to my review of the Marvel Select Movie Avengers Hulk action figure. So, this figure is pretty awesome. It is my first Marvel Select figure that I have purchased, and I'm going to be purchasing them again. I got this for $27 after tax from my local comic book shop, Mile High Comics. Which, I don't know how many other people around the world actually know of that specific chain, but it's, I think they're very popular, because of the owner, he, like, stumbled upon a big collection of comics and something like that, if I remember. I have ads of Mile High Comics from, like, the 70s, so, that are in, like, comic books of mine, so that's pretty cool. So, before I get into the figure, let me just show you the box real quick. The box is pretty huge, and being that this is my first Marvel Select, this thing was really hard to get into my backpack with all the other stuff I bought. So, yeah, and there's a nice picture on here. This is actually, I display it with this picture. Just, sitting there. Like on the side of a bookshelf. And then there's the back. Hawkeye, Chitauri Foot Soldier, Diamond Select Toys, blah blah blah. You all know that. Man, I'll have to tell you though, this figure is heavy. I mean, for $27, I feel like I got my money's worth. I mean, this Hulk figure is huge. Now, if I can try to get it into the light, because I always have a trouble with lighting, because these lights that I have are not very good. There's a whole bunch of... There you go. Now, the detail on this figure is pretty good. Now, in the end, I'm going to recommend this higher than the Marvel Legends one from the Walmart exclusive. Just because I feel like, you know, as a Hulk, you know, him being bigger isn't necessarily a bad thing. And this one has a lot of good paint shading and everything. It's poseable, so it's basically like having a statue that you can, you know, change the position of. I mean, with action figures, you can just, you know, sit there and pose them and play with them. That's what they're meant for. But I think these are more oriented to the collector market. And this is my first Marvel Select figure. I am going to be purchasing, I'm on the hunt for the Colossus and, the Rhino that comes out next year. Oh my god, I cannot wait for that. Oh man. So, yeah, and I'm still trying to find a Thanos and a Juggernaut, so, yeah. But the big characters are always, I think, worth getting as far as Marvel Select. Now, this figure... And that's some paint on my thumbnail there from model painting yesterday. They're pretty good. Now, I'm going to rate this in three different ways. Paint, sculpt, and articulation. Kind of like, you know, how Ashrock 1982 does with his Marvel Universe reviews. And now, he's heavy. He's about... Oh, I don't know. He weighs about probably as much as the Sentinel does. The Build-A-Figure Sentinel did. He's got a lot of weight to him. A lot in the upper body, though. But, yeah, pretty cool. So, paint. Paint's pretty good. He's got these darker... They're like brown pants. And they got some wash on them. I don't know how well you can actually see that. Because these... For some reason, these lights are, like, really not good at all. But, yeah, he's got some wash. Like, right there. Everything. The green, he's got some dark green. You can see a lot in the chest there. Like, in between the muscles and, you know, the certain lines of... where his muscles are. He's got, you know, his... Fingernails are black, at least where you can see them. His thumbnails are, his toenails are as well. Hulk toes. And, yeah, so, You know, he's coming off in the camera just a little bit darker than he actually is. Which, he's a good shade of green, though. So you don't have to, like, worry about, oh, is he too light colored? Because I think the Marvel Legends one is too lightly colored. Just a one shade off of what I would really prefer. So, that just put me off. And plus, you know, he's a little small. I like to have Hulk, you know, bigger than most. And he is the largest Marvel figure I own now. He's bigger than Terrax. So, yeah, for paint, I'll give him a 5 out of 5. Marvel Select always has the best paint apps out of usually anything that Marvel Legends has. Or at least Marvel Legends Hasbro today. They still haven't got up to Toy Biz standards of, you know, the way they paint washed and everything, but... that's pretty good. Now, sculpt-wise, I think this figure is a very good, just a visual representation of how, you know, Hulk would generally look. Now, in the movie, he wears lighter colored pants. Movie, he's got, like, you can see it in the box art. His pants are, like, tan. More or less, you know, a tan color. Like this, the color of this paint. Like Kemri brown. Oh, but about like that. Now, I believe if I can remember the movie correctly, it's been a couple of weeks since I've seen the movie. He actually had these darker pants during the final battle. But, yeah, sculpt is pretty good. I mean, he's got veins, like through his feet, through his hands. He's got some in his chest there. The hair is very cool. I mean, I've never really had a Marvel Select, but I've never had a Marvel Select figure before. And the hair is just really, really cool. Now, with all figures, you're probably going to get, you know, just a little bit of paint spot. I mean, he's got a little bit of stuff on the side of his cheek, and... he's got a little black speck on his head, which you can't see because this light just utterly sucks. So I apologize, because if I take the light off, you can't see anything. If I go over here, you'll hardly even be able to see the figure without this stupid light. So I don't. I need to get better equipment for this, but yeah, it's pretty cool. So sculpt-wise, you know, I'll give him a 4 out of 5. The head sculpt though, it's cool. I like it. It's just you can't see it. I'm sorry. That is really annoying me that I can't show off any detail in this, because one, the camera sucks. Two, the lights suck. There. So you can see a little bit better. His face, his eyes aren't crooked. At least none of mine. Eyebrows are painted. Pretty good though. Overall, a really good, really awesome figure. So yeah, the sculpt is good for what it is. So I mean, I don't, the mouth doesn't bother me. And he looks angry. He looks, you know, pissed off. So, this camera will just stay here. Stay. So yeah, I mean, I'm gonna give this figure a perfect score anyway, but as far as, you know, paint and sculpt and the articulation for Marvel Select is actually very good. He's got, you know, pretty good up. You know, okay down, not too much. He just really just looks forward and up just slightly. But he can turn his head. He's got a pretty good waist or torso joint. And he is very tight when you open him. You gotta be careful. I thought I was gonna break him when I got him out and started messing with him. His arms go forward. They go in pretty well. He's got single jointed biceps, but they're like ratcheted. So, yeah, and the wrist rotate. His arm also goes out, and you can see the paint. It kind of gunks up in there. I think that's why a lot of these, he's got a bicep swivel, if I didn't already mention that. That's why these joints are usually always tight, because the paint gets in there. He doesn't have a waist joint, which if he had a waist joint, I think that'd make this figure so much better, but since he does not, I mean, it doesn't mess it up. I mean, he usually just stands there looking super awesome and imposing and just towering over everyone else in my display. So he doesn't really have to worry. That doesn't bother me. His hips go back, forward, and see they ratchet. They lock in this, and then they go back, and then they lock in that. They do go out, but it's a lot like the DC Universe Classics joints. How it's, you know, that T crotch, and then they got the crotch pits. It does have that. So you gotta, and with him, like, you pull it out, you gotta be careful because this will get loose, and it feels like you're gonna break it. So I usually just put my thumb right here on the T. Like, you see how it forms that T, I just put it right there and hold that down when you move his legs out. And they move out, you know, pretty much all the way, so he can get a good, you know, ninja kick out of it. So, just try to be careful with the legs. I think are the most fragile part right there at the hips. His, knees, or his legs swivel up there at the upper part of the thigh. He bends at the knee, and they're kind of stiff too because of the, you know, they ratchet the same as the arms do. And the feet, they go, they don't really go forward. They go back pretty far though. And, yeah, you want to see something really cool? This is my favorite part. Boom. He's got ankle pivot. Oh my god. When did they start? Did they start doing this with Colossus? Because that is like the most awesome thing ever. I saw that in Sharingus Prime's video and I'm like, I mean, I was already kind of wanting the figure anyway, but the ankle pivot just sold it. I mean, because then you could get him into some really, just really cool poses, and his feet are flat on the ground. Oh, the ankle pivot! Oh, yeah! Sorry. Oh, no, I'm not sorry. That's awesome. Who would ever think a Marvel Select would have ankle pivot? Oh, my God. Oh, man, it made me so happy, and I'm still all geeked out about it, because just look at that. Oh, man, I love this figure. So, yeah, articulation is, I want to say like a 5 out of 5 because of that. But if he had a waist swivel, that would probably, he would be the best. I mean, yeah, okay, double jointed knees and elbows. But, I mean, I don't mind the single jointed knees and elbows on bigger characters like this, because they're so big, they're so imposing, they don't really need to move around a whole lot to whoop the crap out of you. Hulk doesn't. He just kind of has to turn around and punch you in the face, and that doesn't take that much effort for him. So I can see why, you know, single jointed elbows and knees don't really bother me that much. So, yeah, I recommend getting this figure. If you go find him at your comic book shop or wherever you can, I'm not entirely sure where they actually sell them other than the comic book store, because that's the only place I've ever seen them. I haven't really walked into the Disney store, though, so I actually do want to go in there, because, you know, I do like some Disney movies, plus they got Marvel stuff in there, plus the Lego store is in the mall as with the Disney store, so, plus there's a Toys R Us across the street, and so, yeah, eventually, but, with all that said, if you can find them, I'd say get him. If you're thinking about getting him, I'd say go ahead and pull that trigger, because this is an awesome Hulk to have. So, real quick, before this video is done, let me straighten him completely out and see how big he is compared to other stuff, because this guy's huge. So this video will probably be like 16 or 17 minutes. So, let's see. I have a bunch of random stuff I can show you. Let's see. Transformers Prime, Voyager Starscream. Yeah, we can put him with Thanos. And guy now. He was a... He was an Xbox 360 game. It's kind of a... And that's standard disc size for anything. So yeah, he's bigger than most stuff. Way bigger than Starscream. Fairly large. A lot larger than Thanos, as you can see. And compared to, you know, Red Dead Redemption, he's about the same as Thanos, actually. That's kind of interesting. Yeah, he's pretty big. So, I'll put him with the rest of my Avengers that I display him with. Turn out this camera. Yeah, so, like, from here you can see he's pretty big, but I like it. I think it works out. I mean, Thor's taller than Captain America, than Bucky Cap, and Bucky Cap shorter than Steve Rogers, the original Captain America, and, you know, Iron Man's probably about the same, but I like the way these guys look together. Now, I will be getting the modern Thor to replace that Thor. If I can find it, I've seen it only a few times and I haven't picked it up, and then when I finish the wave and then I need Thor last, I didn't find him anymore, so, but yeah. And stay tuned for more Marvel Legends reviews, because I'm actually going to be reviewing the new Terrax wave eventually when I get, probably here in the next few days. I'm going to be reviewing, like, Claw and Constrictor and some of the lesser, I guess, popular ones, and go for it. And this Bucky Cap's the only one from Series 2 that I have. So, yeah, I still have yet to see the full wave of Series 2 outside of Toys R Us, so I'm just waiting to see the rest of them, so I can pick and choose and get a complete Zola, but... That's gonna be a while, so thanks guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Peace!